BRWCE, reigniting backyard wrestling.
Hi everyone, welcome to WCE Better Alive. I'm Jim Bob McDaniel on commentary, and we are set for our first match, a threat match, to determine the most contender for the All Out Championship, and here comes Chris Charles.
Chris is backstage.
Bobby got a little swagger.
Not my color.
Traitor!
Over the hat.
Look.
Over the hat. Thanks, brother.
There you go.
Those two have some sort of hot interactions.
Introducing the second participant,
Jay Styrio. Jay Styrio made his debut last year at Fighter Fright.
Jay Styrio!
Looks all pumped up to be in this match. Wrestlers wiping their feet before they get in the ring. We are battling Color Nature during his events. Bringing high and off. And we'll be right back at this brief commercial message, so don't go anywhere.
Hi everybody, Sean Jovi here. Be sure to go on my YouTube channel and check out all my stuff. www.youtube.com/RCWRules. That is RCWRULZ. Please come and check out my latest vlogs, my old matches, my old shows from my old fed, and more. Please be sure to like, subscribe, and all that fun stuff, or I'll kick your ass so hard you'll be living on a prayer. See you there.
Introducing the final participant.
Wait a minute. I recognize this entrance theme. It can't be. It's changed up a little bit, but I don't know who it is. No way!
There, oh!
He's Cash Andrews! He's alive! We haven't seen Cash Andrews since Fighter Fright 2. After his match with Dream of Rage in that 3 Kings of Hell. New shades and new shirts. Wait a minute. WCE commissioner Mark Packer trying to tell Jay Styrio that Omaha has not won yet, but he can't score a pinball. Three for this miss had to be in the ring before the match starts.
Get in the ring, Dad! Get in the ring!
Welcome back!
But if the belt had run, we actually had Rey Mysterio be number contender for the All-Out belt.
Settle down. Easy, boy.
Well, you better take it easy. Dash Andrews taking his time to get in the ring. He's in the ring.
Y'all ready? Keep it clean. Ring the bell.
And Mark Tacker singles from Bell, and we are underway. And Rey Mysterio striking first by Prince Charles, who is still wearing his sunglasses, kind of his trademark.
Watch the fist.
Off the corner. And a big back elbow.
You get a chance.
Dash cheering on Rey Mysterio. Hell. Yeah. I would let those two beat the hell out of each other. Well, now Dash Andrews and Rey Mysterio locking up our elbow. Side headlock. And a headlock takeover. Alright. Oh. Head scissors. Rey Mysterio trying to kick out of it. Still trying to kick out of it, but Dash Andrews still has a hold on it, and he breaks out of it. And, oh, going for a step toe hold. Excuse me. Yeah, fly going for my mouth a little bit. Oh, Irish brought the ropes. And, oh, yeah. Oh, rough clothesline. Rough but effective. Oh! Yeah, big boot by Prince Charles.
I just big boot your big head ass. Next boy.
And our hard camera is actually closer to the ring than usual, trying to battle the elements here. Big boot and a spear. Oh my goodness. Mark Hackbar check on Prince Charles, but it's okay. Dash Andrews showing a new side of himself, per se.
Beat him up, Andrews, beat him up. Beat him up, Andrews.
Front headlock in.
Beat him up,
Andrews. And Rey Mysterio go for a small package. Oh. Try to make sure he throws it down. One count. Andrews kicks out. Prince Charles tried to break it up.
Get up!
Was that a fatality? Some sort of far maneuver. We are no strangers of move stuff here in WCE. Rey Mysterio working Dash Andrews into the corner. Oh, and a Flair style chop. Our cameras will try to catch all the action in the ring. And hopefully outside of it, hurting these battle elements in Wisconsin. Rey Mysterio bring Prince Charles in the corner. And a side elbow, body splash. Shades of the Stinger out there. And oh, whips Prince Charles right to Dash Andrews. Up and are down. Rey Mysterio still standing.
Lucha, 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 lucha.
And a little.
Don't get him started.
Oh, don't get Rey Mysterio started indeed. Channeling his. Channeling his inner Eddie Guerrero. Oh, and a suit play right there. Rey Mysterio crawling over to the cover. One, two, and Dash Andrews breaks up the pin. Once again, folks, this is for the number one contender spot for the All Out Championship. Where it's against Craven Rage. Well, it will be against Craven Rage at Vindication 2. And, oh, yeah, kick right to the ribs. Craven Rage and Catalyst face off with each other later on tonight in a last champion standing match. Dash Andrews with that Rolling Thunder type maneuver. Now Dash Andrews in control of the match suddenly. Throwing those hits at Prince Charles, reeling through the ropes. Irish whip. And like a modified chop block. Like the shades of Steve Bongo McMichael right there. Off the second rope. Eight. It is a low ceiling indeed. Going to the top rope. This is sketch.
Please don't die. Please don't die.
And an elbow drop.
My God. From the rafters of the tent.
Two. Oh, and Jay Stero breaks up the cover. Jay Stero going to the corner.
You're too tall. It's too tall.
Jay Stero does have a height advantage, I think, but...
What is happening? Don't die, please.
And a frog splash. We are having our ring in the tent. Just to battle the weather here in Wisconsin. Jason Joe throwing the match. Irish whip on Chris Charles. And Chris Charles rolling. And a code breaker. Nice.
Come on, guys.
All three men are down.
Okay. One.
Mark Packer counting all three men out.
Two.
Come on, Chris. Come on, Dan. Come on.
We're three. At three counts.
I don't have a license. Four.
I think one's got to be up to break it.
One's got to get up.
Yeah, one of them. I believe that's the rule. It matches up first. Prince Charles and Jay Stereo. Shortly after. Ooh. That was like a closed fist. Oh, a super kick. Yeah, an arm super kick. Luckily, he didn't kick Mark Packer in the face. And a. Those were a Sambo slam. Almost kind of like a rock bottom or a stereo bottom. I don't know what he's trying to do to Dash Andrews here.
Uh-oh.
Another. Oh. Dash Andrews kicking out of it. Knees to the gut. Uh-oh. And a suplex. Oh! Dash Andrews back on Prince Charles. Oh. Probably going for an RC flex on Prince Charles. Oh, Charles is trying to fight out of it. He's the gut. And Jay Spiro's joining the fray. Oh, what's going on here? Could it be a double suplex? No. Not Charles! Oh! Charles lost his shades. And Mark Packer finally just setting it aside of Prince Charles. Andrews and Jay Stereo going back up. Oh, strike. Jay Stereo for another strike. Strike. And we got Stereo Johnson here working the strikes. And a stereo bottom. And, no. And a stereo shuffle. That connected. Stereo up to his feet. But Prince Charles going back to his feet here. What's going on? Oh! Claymore kicked by Jay Stereo. Covering Dash Andrews. And Dash Andrews kicks out, but Prince Charles actually has enough strength to try to break the pin. And a cover on Prince Charles. And a two count. Both, all three men got to be spent in this match. It's pretty grueling so far, I gotta say for myself. It's a hell of a contest. Oh, and Prince Charles, and Prince Charles doing here. Oh, a Charles DDT.
Hey, you ever order crab legs for dinner?
No, I don't like crabs.
It's Wisconsin, we don't like crab legs. Oh, what's it going for?
Something tells me we're going to Boston, folks.
It might be going to Boston. But, oh, wait a minute. That's a... That is a unique submission.
Give up. No.
Very nice special. What is Jay Stereo trying to...
Here, let go.
Shit.
No.
Jay Stereo trying to do something here. Oh. I think Prince Charles should have let go of that submission.
You should have let go, Charles.
What Mark Packer said. But the damage Dash Andrews has been done.
Hey, Dash.
Jay Stereo. Trying to get back on Prince Charles' submission. Oh, wait a minute. It's a crossface.
Get back, Charles.
No.
Charles is...
Charles
is trying to reach the rope, and he does. Oh, and an elbow by Dash Andrews on the top of the shoulder of Jay Stereo. Surprised Dash Andrews is still walking after that, I want to call it the Saturday Night Special. That crab leg lock and a cat mutilation by Dash Andrews.
No.
Taking the page of Nicholas Prentice's book. And Prince Charles back up. And locks in another Saturday Night Special. And Dash Andrews lets go of the calculation. But Prince Charles has got ropes. Mark Packer unaware.
Watch it.
You see nothing, pal.
And uh-oh. Jay Stereo back on the bomb rope. Oh! Some sort of karate kid fucking kick right there. It's part of my language, but this is a cluster right here. Oh, small package. One, two. Another small package. Small package again. Two. These men will do anything to get that double contender spot for the all-out title. Andrews. Oh! And a stomp by Dash Andrews onto Jay Stereo right in the chest. And a spear by Prince Charles. Shades go flying again. Jay Stereo back up. Uh-oh. Jay Stereo tuning up the band. And a sweet stereo music cover. And Dash Andrews pulls Jay Stereo off of Prince Charles. And Dash Andrews showing a vicious side of himself in this match. A new rough and tough and attitude here. Brings Jay Stereo up. Reverse DT. Oh! I don't know what to call that. Cover. One, two. Prince Charles breaks up the pin.
Come on, that was three.
That was two.
Dash Andrews complaining to the Mark Packer about the count. Andrews back up. Andrews looking like he's frustrated. Wait a minute. Wait, Prince Charles is actually having words of...
You suck at calling. I'm not even fucking...
Having words of Mark Packer. But wait a minute. I believe Andrew just low blowed stereo.
Come on, Charles.
I don't give a shit because I'm winning.
And a spear! A spear by Prince Charles. Andrews bails. He low blowed stereo.
You okay?
Yep. Walks out. Charles. Cover. One, two, three. And Prince Charles is the number one contender for the All Out belt. I don't know what the hell just happened.
Winner of the match and number one contender for All Out belt, Prince Charles.
I'm baffled, folks. Prince Charles gets the number one contender spot for the All Out belt and putting glasses on Mark Packard. As official, folks, what a match to open up the WCE Better Alive. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back after this short message. Don't you go anywhere.
Woo!
Prince is back. Back again. Prince is back.
Hey folks, it's Nicholas Krenzen here to let you know you need to be checking out Sportswire Radio. Find them on Facebook by searching for Sportswire Radio, YouTube, searching Sportswire Radio, and you can also find them at sportatorium.com/player, as well as soundcloud.com/thesportsreport2019. Go check it out and give Reverend Tom the WCE love.
For that is the Wildcat Rumble for the coin ticket.
As well as all about talent.
Hell yeah!
Hell yeah! Yeah. No dirty from the top of the ring here.
Let's go to me!
Alright.
Good
job, Charles.
Packers suck.
Scott Bear Cat Center.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jim Bob Daniels back here on commentary for the Wild Card Rumble for this year. Looks like a packed ring more than last year. Last year we only had four people, or five. I don't know. I wasn't really there. But, oh, and a sidekick by Don Filios on Darkfire. Tyler Arks in there, splashing Prince Charles, who just won the All Out more contender spot. We also got Jason Hero in here as well. And we also got it's like Zombronus and Hollowed from the Zombronus from the Future Classic Division. Hollowed. Haven't seen that guy since Firefight 1 from 2021. But oh, it's like we're all ganging up on Zombronus. And Chase still trying to direct traffic here. Oh, Zombros getting ganged up on. I want to say Zombros is the second biggest guy in the match. And Zombros. Zombros is out. Oh, Darkfire. On a Dos Filios. Hollowed on Prince Charles. Our cameras are trying to catch close to the action here.
Merry Christmas!
And oh, what's Prince Charles trying to do here? Trying to spring up over the rope? Or trying to reach Hollowed? Oh, Jesus. And Prince Charles is out.
Distract me, boy.
But if you guys just missed it, Tyler Arch just delivered a fucking, pardon my language again, a like a fisherman DT buster on Jay Stereo. Oliver, get back in the ring. Oliver, get back in the ring. He doesn't want to get pushed out to the outside. Oh, Jay Stereo up the second rope. Wild splash in the back of Tyler Arc. Adonis moving out of the way last second. but he gets kicked right in the face for his trouble. Follows that dark fire. And a... Oh, yeah, kicked by Darkfire and Hollow's out. Hollow. Hollow is not, does not look pleased, I think. And, Hollow! Scaring the hell out of Mark Packer. Now we got a final four here. Tyler Arc, Adonis Filios, Darkfire, and Jay Stereo. Which I'm surprised Jay Stereo's still up after that spear from the earlier match with Prince Charles. Darkfire striking Jay Stereo. I still have some effects from that spear. Also, this guy hit with our spear. Darkfire, and a super kick by Jay Stereo. And it doesn't have no effect on Adonis Filios. And Adonis Filios feeling no effects from the strikes. Oh god, what's Tyler Arc doing? Bomb rope. Oh Jesus!
Shit Christ!
That didn't look good. Nor did it feel good. Now Filios is the only one standing in the ring, and he's the biggest one in the ring, for that matter. Well, Tyler Arc did go to the bottom.
You gotta go where it's
top rope. Oh, I ain't going to top rope.
And.
Okay, he's out.
Well, I guess Tyler Arc's out. Mark Packer using referee's discretion during that elimination.
Down three.
Final three, Darkfire, Adonis, and Jay Stereo with a super kick. See, he's been trying to get Adonis over the top rope, can he? Yeah, he got it! Big Ben go flying. Now it's down to Darkfire and Jay Stereo, who will hold the golden ticket for this year of 2023. The person who holds the golden ticket has one full season to cash in. Last year holder being Dash Andrews, who failed to cash in and successfully win a championship. And Jay Stereo. Jay Stereo. And sweet stereo music. Or super kick. Whatever the hell you want to call it. Pulled out a Heartbreak Stereo right there, staying in the match. Five Stereo shuffle. Darkfire back up. Abdom. Stunner! Stunner from the pits of hell. It's Stereo. Stereo is eliminated. And Darkfire has won the golden ticket. He has all of the 2023 season to cash in on any title he chooses. Whether it be All Out, Interstate Openweight, or I guess RCW if you want to count that. I got to talk to Sean Jovi on that one. But Mark Packer getting hugged by the sweaty Darkfire. Darkfire is the 2023 golden ticket holder. Perhaps the first step into achieving a championship in this season. We'll find out, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back after this messages.
Insane Wrestling.
We have here our resident rock star and RCW World Underground champion Sean Jovi about to go up against the AIW champion in a champion vs. champion showdown. Woo! Sean Jovi. The AIW World Champion, the Grip King, Adonis Filios. This is the second meeting between these two men, these two behemoths of champions. And today, Adonis is looking to get a win back on Mr. Jovi. Last time these two met, Jovi finished off Adonis with a bed of roses. Checking on both of them. WCE Dead or Alive with our champion showcase of the RCW champion Sean Jovi versus the Drip King, the AIW champion Adonis Filios. And we're going off with the test of strength right here, folks.
Jovi getting the advantage early on.
No, wait. Filios. Powering up. Listen. He's got it. Jovi. He's got the advantage over Jovi now. you, Seth. These two men, these two men are both evenly matched. But the last time they fought, John Jovi. I think the Crypt King remembers that. He has a history of shoulder issues. Big swabbing blow to the head of Jovi by the honest.
Easy.
And the Crypt King showing some new attitude today. I think he's taking Jovi a little bit more seriously than he did the last time they fought.
Come on, he's
the champion. Oh, and a big chop by Jovi to another big shot. Another one. Uranage. Arakanage. And kick out.
Two. Don't crush me.
See ya.
And Joe gets the headlock back in on Adonis.
You good, Adonis?
Come on.
He's got that headlock locked in really well. And big shots on the bounce to the gut of Jovi, trying to break that helmet. And they're getting closer to Rose here. Scared by Adonis! That was dripping gold! I don't know, it looks like he's set up for another spear. Jovi. I don't know. Another one!
Come on, Jovi!
wants it.
Jovi! Alright, Jonathan's a big man! Oh, it's great! Come on, men down though, big, wonderful
one.
Match here.
Finish it!
Two! Three!
Get up, Jovi!
Come on, Jovi!
Four!
He's got it going on here.
Finish it!
Five!
Just like his vlog, he has got it going on.
Come on,
six! He's up!
And they're both up.
Looking cool. And with a call to Enzyte about natural male enhancement, Bob is living large. In a few short weeks, Bob has a big new spring of confidence, a generous swelling of pride, and the one thing every man deserves, a little well-earned respect from the neighborhood. Enzyte is not available in stores, but now you can call and save up to 40% on a trial pack. Enzyte, the effective, reliable way to natural male enhancement.
send me not adventures. A stranger guiding me, traveling through time to change the future. How will the song end?
You know, it is great to be back. And earlier tonight, I was in a triple threat match to determine the number one contender for the All Out Championship. I think you are all wondering why I did what I did. Why I let Prince Charles become the number one contender.
Why are you doing it?
Why? I'd like to welcome out Prince Charles out to the ring right now. Now, Prince, before you start talking, I want to officially, welcome you to my show.
Thanks for having me.
Should we tell the people why the outcome happened in our triple threat?
Quite simple. Well, I don't know if it's simple to you idiots in the out there.
Get my mic back.
But I remember last year when me and this handsome young fella right here, he was on my breaking news. And I remember I chewed him up and spit him out on my show. And I basically embarrassed him. But all season afterwards, I saw him in the ring. I saw him give it his all. I saw him bring out the intensity, the darkness inside of him. And I loved every single minute of it. So, before his match against, let's say, Craven Rage, Fight or Fright, before, I went to him and I told him I was wrong about you. If anything, you're the face of this company. So I told him, if you did become world champion for this company, also known as the All Out right now, I was going to promise that nobody, not anybody in this company, would mess with you ever again. Not even Craven Rage.
Speaking of Craven Rage, you don't have to face him next month, right? Does that make you feel comfortable going against the one you mentored, not mentored, but you looked up to, who mentored you throughout the whole season?
Well, I still do look up to him. But it's like I said, it's like what we talked about before. This place is gonna have to need a new face around here. Maybe I could be the next ruler of the yard. So Craven, I love you, man, like a brother, but I've been watching you on commentary. I've been studying you. Yeah. Why you think I've been commentating every single match you were in, pal? I took notes. Everything you do, everything you say, every time you put a move on somebody, I've watched every single moment of it. I still have it in my head, in my mind, and when I wrestle you, you ain't gonna get somebody on commentary. You ain't gonna get some schmuck kissing up to you. You're gonna get the Prince Charles in full effect, because the Prince is back.
And that is all for today's episode of Death.
Well, let's see how this goes.
Joey's vlog has got it going on. All I watch and I view it all day long. Jovi, did you see what my target was for me? I know it might be wrong, but I'm a fan of Jovi's vlog.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Becker.
We are back here, ladies and gentlemen. Jim Bob McDaniel's back here on commentary.
Championship.
Interstate Championship, no more contender spot on the line here. And here comes the new Messiah, Nicholas Crenson. Talking jive with the crowd here. The disrespect from Crenson here.
You should tell the fans how it feels.
And even wearing that current the frog shirts is disrespect, but that's not my business. And here comes Tyler Arc. But what kind of mask is that? Well, I dig the sweater, but the mask is, I don't know. Now, people don't like, the fans don't like Nicholas Crenson and Tyler Arc, so this might be a treat to enjoy these two beat the hell out of each other. You gotta wipe your feet before you get in the ring. We're still battling the elements here in Wisconsin. And we're having hard cam camera difficulties, so we're sticking with the roam cam, ladies and gentlemen.
Ring the bell!
Apparently Mark Packer's rang the bell this time. And oh, collar elbow tie up from Mark and Crenson. Right to the corner. And that was a clean break. Very uncharacteristic. And another collar elbow. This time Crenson is on the offense, but a clean break. Once again, uncharacteristic. Oh. Test of strength here. Oh, it's like Granson on the offense, and oh, this could be a treat here, folks. Oh, side headlock from Ark on Granson. Run to the ropes. And wait, what the hell is this? What the hell? Ladies and gentlemen, Tyler Ark is the number one contender for the Interstate Championship.
You see what I told you? I told you I had a plan all this time.
We had a plan all this time. Welcome to the newest member of Vector.
Winner, Tyler.
What the hell is this? What the hell? Ladies and gentlemen, pardon my language, but this is bullshit. Wait a minute, what's going on here? They're attacking Mark Packer!
Don't look at me.
Those sons of bitches.
Oh boy.
Damn them. Damn them! Don't you
do it, doesn't it?
Oh, you son of a bitch! He just laid out Mark Packer.
That's what you get, Mark Packer.
I think he said you're gonna make a whole lot of chaos for Mark Packer. But I believe Linda had something to do with this. This is ridiculous.
I don't need to focus on the interstate title right now. Because Sean Jovi, your time's coming.
Good God.
Oh, no!
last month.
Thank you.
right there.
One.
I can't believe it. The size of James Marshall. I can't believe he picked him up and slammed him down. Now he's punching him right on that top of his head.
Get out,
James!
Whoa!
Two!
He is on top.
Three!
Holy shit!
Two!
Holy shit! Holy shit!
Right here.
Four.
Oh, the Raven Rage is
six more seconds left.
I don't know what's going on here.
Marshall, get back!
Look! Oh, that's our first foul of this year!
No way!
but I don't know.
This is too much. I mean, you know how much of a fan of Raymond Reyes, but not only did he disrespect the Callis and his family,
the yard now, just imagine if he does go for the interstate champion.
He might be the
king
of the world.
You
if they leave James Marshall, he might need some attention here.
What a match this was.